here we have the Urban Hydrolink, and it's one option for teaching about the water and wastewater systems that we all depend on. So our first component is always going to be our source. And here we've got a representation of a river being surface water. And then we're going to pump some of that water into our water treatment system. So this water treatment is representing how it would move through our flocculation basin, the filter, disinfection, and the clear well. And then moving up into water storage. Water storage is part of our distribution system, so that would be our third component. And from distribution, we go into the household, so water usage. Moving from distribution to the household is often happening underground, and therefore it's a bit out of sight, out of mind. After the water is used in the household, it's collected into another centralized system where we're going to have our water again moving underground, and now it's our wastewater. And this also requires energy to be able to move that water into our wastewater treatment. Our wastewater treatment is a very simple representation of primary and secondary, with secondary being an aeration basin, representing there being a microbial component, a biological component to wastewater treatment. And then ultimately moving through a tertiary treatment and then back to a natural source of water. And in this system here, we have a loop, but this could be representative of downstream. You might have another community that's doing a very similar thing, pulling water and moving it through. And so thus here we have all seven components of our water and wastewater system represented to try to help educate students and citizens in general.